My guest this week is Carly Fiorina, the former CEO of Hewlett-Packard and U.S. Senate candidate from California, and now she's with the Unlocking Potential Project. Thanks so much for coming in.
Hey, it's great to be with you.
Thank you for having me. So what exactly were you trying to do here in New Hampshire this week?
Well, we're trying to launch, and we did launch this morning in a great breakfast with over 200 women and men, an effort to get women at the grassroots to engage with other women, Republican women and independent women, and talk about the issues and talk about why our policies really are better for women, better to unlock potential, and to combat as well the ridiculous, shameless, baseless propaganda of the Democratic Party that somehow we're waging a war on women.
And by you say "are," you mean the Republican Party.
Yes, the Republican Party.
So you're picking six states.
Yes.
New Hampshire, of course, got a history of electing women into
office.
Absolutely,
absolutely.
So why is New Hampshire one of those states to target, given that we have such high involvement anyway?
Well, this isn't just about electing women, although of course that's very important. It's about talking with women about all of the issues, because all issues are women's issues. We're 53% of the voters. Mm-hmm. But in states like New Hampshire, Virginia, North Carolina, Michigan, Colorado, and Iowa, all of those six states that I just named, they're purple states, they're swing states, and therefore they're states where women are going to make a big difference. And so we think it's really important to motivate at the grassroots level women to speak with other women, because we know that women are most influenced by women they know.
And is there a particular race you're looking at, or is this more about the grassroots?
No, this is about helping all of our candidates, really. Mm-hmm. So it's not about a particular race. It's really about getting women more politically active, perhaps not as candidates, but perhaps as people who are interested in the issues and want to talk with other women about those issues.
Great. Thanks so much for coming in.
It's my pleasure.
Now, you can read more about state-level politics at WMUR.com/politicalscoop, and that's also where you can find an extended version of this interview. But that does it here for TV. Now, back to you. We have a few more minutes here online. I want to talk to you. There was an interesting story that was in Politico this past week, and you probably saw it, about the money gap, is what they put it. The gap between men who give major money into these super PACs and women. The differences, I think, were dramatic. If you take the top 10 women, it's around $8 million. The top men, it's like $50 million. Why do you think that gap is there? It's not just about engagement and getting phones ringing for office, but also about giving money.
Well, you know, in many cases, traditionally, sadly, people who were seeking money went to men.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And I think there's been a gap in recognizing that there are lots of women who have means as well. But I also think we know that women and men process things differently, and different messages appeal to them. So I've said that all issues are women's issues, mm-hmm. because we're half the nation, we're more than half the voters. But just for an example, on health care, you know, men tend to talk, if you're a Republican, men tend to talk about government overreach, but women respond better to something that says, factually, women are losing access to their doctors here in New Hampshire. Women are losing access to their health insurance. Women are losing access to their hospitals. Women are losing access to the procedures that their doctors recommend. And so I think we need to tap the potential of women to be more actively engaged in fundraising, in door-to-door, in helping candidates or running for office themselves. And we need to recognize that sometimes women think about the issues differently, although they care about all issues.
Let's talk tactically. How does your organization work? How will you exactly motivate people
to
get more involved?
Great question. So we have a statewide director. We're going to be hiring people on the ground. We're going to be training women who say, I want to get involved, I want to get engaged. So with full-time staff and training operations, we're then going to have a very specific set of goals. You know, one of the things we know is that leaving a voicemail for someone is not the most effective way to persuade them. Mm-hmm. The most effective way to persuade them is actually to have a conversation with them. And so we're going to be really clear about what we're trying to get done and measuring that we're getting that done.
You Democrats did a press conference call before your visit.
I consider it a badge of honor.
You know what? I was a little surprised they did it, to be quite frank with you, that they did it. It's not an official Republican Party visit for you. This is your organization. They say that, you know, when you were CEO, you had to lay off about 200 people in Nashua. So you're coming from out of state, trying to tell people what's happening. What do you respond to?
Well, you know, I'm very proud of my time as CEO of Hewlett-Packard. We doubled the company from $44 billion to $90 billion. We improved the growth rate from 2% to 9%. We generated 11 patents a day. We created market-leading positions in every product category and every market segment. And certainly while you're going through the toughest technology recession in 25 years, some tough choices need to be made. But net net, we grew jobs in this country. We grew jobs in this region. And so, you know, I'm proud of that record. This is not about me telling anyone what to do. This is about galvanizing the women of New Hampshire to talk to other women that they know in New Hampshire about the issues that they know those women care about in terms they can understand.
Great. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.
And thank you for watching WMUR.com.